Okay, so before we get into today's episode, first of all, I would like to say thank you for clicking on this video and taking the time off of your day to actually watch this content. So there's actually a lot going on in my life right now. We just had a leadership event not too long ago, a couple of weeks ago. It was a three-day event at Frisco. I'm not gonna get too much into that in the intro. I'll talk about it later on in the video. I don't wanna bore you guys. So for the few people that have been wondering, hey Fahim, where the heck have you been for the past couple of weeks? I'm in my car right now. Or maybe not all the time, but basically, yeah, I'm driving to work right now. I'm actually a business and a marketing analyst for a company called MTX. Again, I'll get more into details about that later on in the video. So with all that being said, let the episode start. And give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And subscribe. And, you know, all that other stuff that they say.
Hey, what's up?
So I asked you guys if you guys had any questions about work, school, life, or internships, or anything like that, and you guys actually reached back, and we actually got a decent amount of questions. Some of them were actually really good. Who wants to start?
I think
Imran, are you okay?
Are you guys good?
He's eating paper, I
think. Bro, I feel like Famita's in the back purposely.
I think she should answer the questions instead of me, because what am I going to say?
No, I'm fine. Yeah, might as well. We'll have more footage. So this person asked, I have a 1.5 GPA. What can I do, guys? So the best approach to this, reach out to your teachers, reach out to your counselors. They have special programs. They have English courses. They have math courses. Figure out what your weaknesses are and then narrow it down. So if you're weak in math, reach out to the math lab and then actually find out what topics are holding you back and then what you can do to improve on. Because look, things are going to be hard. It just depends on what you actually see yourself doing in the long run. That's what I think. What about you guys?
Yeah. I would try not like putting that on your resume and try getting like experience that you can put on your resume instead of your GPA, because I don't think people care that much about your GPA after a certain point, but I don't know.
No, I mean, it just depends on what you're in. If you're a freshman, You have a lot of time to improve, but if you're a senior in high school and you have a 1.5, I would recommend just going to a community college, getting your credits in at a cheaper rate instead of paying extra to go to a college. They take more courses that you already took in high school. It's just going to be pointless. But hey, that's going to be on you. When is the best time to shadow my profession? I think it just depends on what you want to know and how fast, because a lot of people just think they need to know everything within that time range. Like, people when they're 20 act like they're 40, but when they're 40, they go back to their 20 state.
That's
and they're like,
favorite thing to say.
Because it's so real. It makes sense. Think about it. I mean, if you have the connections, go for it, because everything nowadays is just network-based. But yeah, no, good question.
Thank you.
Another person asked, best way to network throughout college? That's actually a good question. So I don't know which college you're actually going to, but I know for a fact every college has their own career fairs. Like UNT, for example, we had a business fair not too long ago, and then from that, organizations, and you actually got a chance to actually put yourself out there, have your resume up front, and then talk to them on a personal level. You might be able to get some good relations out of that, get your business card out there. But honestly, just start talking to your professors, your counselors are there on campus. Yeah, I'll take an apple. But going back to the point, best way to network is just by talking out to people, getting out of your comfort zone. The second you're comfortable, that's when you're losing. You want to make sure you're comfortable with being uncomfortable. And then from there, you'll be able to reach out to other people from other organizations. Like, how did you get this job? How did you get MTX?
Well, just use your connections and, like, make friends. Like, be nice to people. If you're just being shy, then you're not going to get anything out of it.
So this person asked, what is college like and how hard are classes? So I actually ended up doing IB. So that actually took a lot of stress out of college. Sure, high school was stressful. I had basically no free time. That actually helped me out in the long run. I didn't have to take all my basic core classes in college. It just depends on what your major is, because every major fluctuates when it comes to the hardness scale from 1 to 10. Because you have business and then you have neuroscience. Obviously, the jump is going to be huge and it's going to be drastic when it comes to workload. It just comes down to how you focus on your tasks. I love keeping calendars on myself. If nothing's on my calendar, I'm never going to get it. It's just not going to happen. So just being work-oriented and being organized is going to help you. It's going to help you a lot when it comes to college and just courses in general. I think I'm going to have to cut out a lot of these questions.
When you're not eating?
I'm not hungry.
Can I have it?
Yeah, you can have it. All right, so this person asked, do a podcast with me. Let me know when you're in Denton. Yes, we are actually planning on releasing a podcast. Not now, but sometime later soon. Be on the lookout. So yes, we are planning on starting our own podcast. Who invited you?
Actually fun.
Be on the lookout for...
Even though I'm not invited.
For some advice.
No, you already know what the vibes are. But yes, we are planning on starting a podcast. I will tell you the name. Four Spice.
You have not answered my question.
Oh my god, I'll get to
That's
it.
That's not the official name.
Two pieces of apple.
Four Spice is not the official.
But yeah, okay. So this person asked, what is the most important thing you learned about your tenure? Need not be technical. So during my internship, I actually learned a lot, not only when it comes to, like, you know, things on a personal level, but things on a wider scale as well. You basically get to learn what other people do as well. Whether or not if you're technical or analytical, you end up learning a lot of perks and a lot of techniques. Like, for example, I was a business analyst for some time, and I learned a lot of skills when it comes to communicating, knowing what the stakeholder actually wants, and then from there you can actually negotiate on the deals. And then to moving on to marketing and knowing what the overall habitual aspect is on a daily basis, what the audience wants versus what you want. So you actually learn a lot of hands-on, because I'm more of a visual person. I'm not book ready, so whenever people are like, yo, this is what you gotta do from a textbook level, it's just not something I can grasp onto unless you're actually hands-on in a visual force or a visual aid kind of situation. So yeah, I would 100% recommend going into an internship and then seeing what that actually brings up upon you. What about you guys?
Definitely something I took out was the leadership quality. Definitely when it came to making sure everything gets done.
All right. Yeah. Interesting. So this person asked, college you get how to? I would say,
Wait, what did they ask?
College you get how to question mark.
College how do you get your question
mark? No. College you get how to question mark. No, you're reading it way too much. College you get how to question mark. I would say,
Very important question.
I would say take English 1 again. I'm kidding. Honestly, just finish high school, get your diploma, and then start applying. Not that hard. All right. So this person actually asked a really good question. I'm trying to secure an internship, but it's so hard connecting with people and getting connections. Are there any events or places where I can network with? That's a good question. So I think I already answered this question. Say it again. Depending on what high school you go to or what college you go to, there's always going to be like some kind of like event where all these organizations are just going to come together, whether if it's a college fair or if it's a business fair or a job fair. You're going to get your chances to talk to these people on a more intimate level. Just have your resume ready. Proofread your resume at least 5 times. Get your counselor to proofread it. And then from there, it's just going to be baby steps. You can't just take on a position that fast in a snap. It's going to take some time. But learn to connect with people, learn to talk, and have that confidence. And then from there, you'll be able to make it, no matter what you do.
Honestly, something I always say, go shadow, you know, somebody you know, your doctor, your physician, your dad's manager, he's a manager.
No, yeah.
What's wrong with going to somebody you know, definitely, because that takes you towards a step to going into somebody you don't know. You start networking better. Nego just takes off.
No, yeah. So this person asked, how do I get into TAMS like Bubba Alvey? Step one, be human. Step two, breathe. Step three, have hair like
it's
me.
It's so easy to get into TAMS.
You did not tell your experience for
you.
Right.
All right, here's another good question. Who should I talk to about a friend who's going through mental issues? That's a lot. Why are you laughing? That's actually a really good question. So when it comes to situations like this, take into account that none of us, even yourself, are qualified counselors or therapists. So even if you've done your research that hand, anything you say isn't going to be right 100%. And in certain cases, you might make things a little bit worse. I would say just bring them comfort, be for them in that moment, and then obviously reach out to another person that's actually qualified when it comes to situations like this. Depending on the household.
Don't even try to like feel sorry for someone and then show them that you feel sorry for them, because that's like the worst thing you can do.
Yeah.
Like, don't give people sympathy because they don't want you to sympathize. They want you to understand. Or just...
No, that's good. That's good. What do you think?
Treat them like a normal person.
Now, how would you approach someone going through mental issues?
I mean, I've been through, like, approaching people with mental issues before. If they don't know you're faking it, just do it. If you're helping them, go ahead. There's nothing wrong with approaching it your way, especially if you're helping. But like Roma said, don't give them false hopes.
Yeah, because none of us are qualified when it comes to stuff like this. All right.
Just for the push as a word.
Hopefully that answered that question. Let's see. So this person asked another good question too. What is one life advice you always live by? That's a good one. One thing that I usually live by is... do what's hard and life will be easy. If you do what's easy, life will be hard. So that just comes down to what you actually do on a daily basis. So taking shortcuts. If you know you can get to the end result by taking a shortcut, you're really not going to get any meaning behind it. Sure, let's say you have a test coming up. You could cheat and copy and paste the answers from someone else, but are you going to really learn the actual lessons from that exam? It's not going to do you any justice. So that's just something I live by. I don't know about you guys.
I think something that I live by, it's not like I lived for that long yet, and it's not like I'm that wise, but all I know is that if you just, like, you can't just keep seeing the negative things in life, because that kind of outlook is really unhealthy. So you need to make sure that you're balancing it out. And, like, if there's something wrong, obviously address it. But you can't just blame yourself for everything, like, bad happening. I don't even know if that means...
I mean, there might be someone out there that might understand what you're saying.
You should cut that out.
Yeah, pretty young, so obviously I don't have that room to say what I live by. But I would say I live by being dedicated to something I like.
Especially in the brown culture.
Especially if there is something that you want to do and get that, like everyone to notice that you did that. It's obviously something you want to go towards. So if you feel like people should see you in this light and respect you in this light, that's how you should be living your life.
I actually have another one.
Really good.
I actually have another one. This one's actually a really good one, too.
If your parents are still working, keep working. So what that basically means is, if your parents are still out there in the workforce, you're not working hard enough. So you want to work and get to that high level in life, to the point where they can just retire. Right? Isn't that right, Will? So they can just live in leisure, and then, you know, it's like a cycle. Like, you know how your parents raised you like a kid?
Once they hit that age, it flips. So now it's your turn to raise them as if they're the child, and it's up to them to just relax and live that nice, easy life. But again, that's just me.
That was good.
So, let's see. So this person asked another good question. I wonder who asked this. How can I implement a good diet into my life without failing? Actually, why don't you start this one?
Oh, I think that
are you?
Just make it a habit. You have like do it for 21 days, and then you should be able to more easily.
You know,
I've never been on a diet. So
must be nice.
Know.
No, it must be
no,
nice.
It's very important. First, you gotta have a goal you wanna set to. Because if you were just starting a diet without any goal.
Yo, the vision board.
Exactly, the vision board. If you don't have that goal, you're not gonna be able to have a success or you're not gonna be able to succeed.
It's like wearing a retainer. Just do it every night. It's not that hard. It's literally just wearing a retainer.
It's literally, metaphorically, metaphysically, just a diet. All right, so this person asked, what school do you even go to? That's a good question. I don't even have a home campus. I'm basically everywhere. So I go to UNT for my main courses, and then I'm basically everywhere else. I was at Baylor not too long ago. I'm going to be in Austin in a couple months. I'm at UTD and UTA every other week because of clubs and organizations. I have people reaching out to me, and they're like, yo, are you going to be in microbiology next week? I'm like, yeah. See, bro.